Hello everyone, I'm Cam and I'm joined here with David from Macworld, and we're here to talk about the iPad Pro 2. So David, when do you think the iPad Pro 2 will be released?
I'm not sure it's going to be very soon, to be honest. We had a lot of optimists saying March, April. We're thinking maybe it was going to be April to coincide with the launch of the Apple Park, the new campus that Apple have built. But it's looking less likely. We had the March event, the March press release event, really, where Apple unveiled the new iPad. Not an iPad Pro 2, though, just a very basic update. And we've also had today, in fact, early April, Apple has got a few journalists in to talk about the Mac Pro. So it's had a couple of separate announcements in spring. I'm not sure they're going to do anything until WWDC at the earliest,
okay.
And that's usually just software. So it could be autumn.
Okay, sure. And what do you think it will look like, this iPad Pro 2?
Generally with iPads, they stick to the formula. There haven't been a lot of changes for a while. I hope they, prove me wrong on this. I've got the iPad Pro 12.9 inch here. It will probably be essentially the same chassis. They're going to maybe trim down the bezels. We're hearing that this year is the year of the bezel-free smartphone, so it might go a bit more sort of edge-to-edge on the screen, which would mean that they could keep the same screen size and trim the size of the chassis.
Sorry about that. Sorry to interrupt. Do you think they will have a 10.5 version inch-wise?
Yeah, so they might. The word we're hearing on the street is that there might be an extra screen size. The idea would be that the 9.7 inch, which is the standard, you remember the very first iPad in 2010? That was 9.7 inch, that's
sure.
The standard size. That's already been updated with the new, it's called iPad, the one that's just come out. Then there'll be a 10.5 inch sort of in betweener, and then a 12.9 inch like this giant. And then you'd also have maybe some more iPad minis on top of that, which I think is madness, is gonna confuse people. But the analysts that are predicting this, they're saying that for some reason that's good for the education sector. I'm not really sure what the thinking is.
People want choice or something like that?
They do. That's always been the Android mentality. I always think that people think they want choice, but they don't. They want to be told what to get. And that was always the Steve Jobs thing. He would just say, I'm going to tell people what they want, and he usually worked with that.
So what do you think the iPad 2 will feature then? What sort of different features will it have?
There's a few different rumours going on at the moment. We think it might get a new Apple Pencil, for one thing. It'll be compatible with the existing Apple Pencil, but they think the Apple Pencil 2 might be magnetic and sort of clip onto the side.
Like the Surface Pro 4?
Yes, possibly.
I believe the Surface Pro 4.
Our producer is doing thumbs up. That it might have a clip on the side so that it doesn't roll, because that's been a common complaint with the Apple Pencil that it lasts forever. I think that sounds horrible, but wait and see. But there's been a lot of talk about the nibs as well, because at the moment, come back to the Surface actually, they have interchangeable nibs, I believe, and the Apple Pencil just has one. So there's talk about making it so you can do more with the stylus. For the actual iPad itself, you could have changed it to the home button to get the haptic home button like on the iPhone 7.
Sure.
You could get 3D touch on the screen. Obviously you would expect spec bumps throughout. Probably an A10X processor would be the fastest. You know what they always say, though, it's the fastest iPad ever, it's the thinnest iPad ever. This and that, and maybe a bit more RAM, that sort of stuff. But yeah, I'm hoping for something exciting. I'm hoping for a proper revamp, but at the moment we don't know. So there you have it.
We'll have to wait and see then.
Thanks for watching, and if you want any more news on the iPad Pro 2, be sure to check out macworld.co.uk.